Hi, David Dilling here from Markzware, and here's yet another interesting one. Another customer sent in an email with the dreaded, I have a bad InDesign file, please help me. This one was a little bit different, that he knew it was an old file, and that there was definitely issues with it, and he couldn't quite figure it out. In any event, the subject of this movie is when InDesign is an InDesign, but QuarkXPress. Yeah, follow me on this one. Well, come check it out on my screen here, because it's quite a common problem. In any event, I'm hearing more and more about this and typing creator being zapped in the file and other issues like this. It's very important, the file extension use and how you use it on a Macintosh. It's not as easy as just adding .indd to a QuarkXPress file and, whoof, magically it becomes an InDesign file. Vice versa, you just can't take a JPEG and add a .tiff and it becomes a TIFF file. It just doesn't work that way. If it did, life would be a lot simpler, but it's just not so. Now, come check it out on my screen, and thank you for watching. Okay, everybody, got an interesting one here. First of all, please excuse my messy desktop. A lot of things going on, things downloading, other bad files, etc. But I got this bad supposed InDesign file in, but there's more to this story. It doesn't appear to be an InDesign file, even though it says .indd and gives us the appearance of an InDesign file. CS3 is picking that up from my system here, which I have primarily running on this machine. However, you'll see if I drop it on FlightCheck, and I'll drop it on our 6.5 beta, which will be out soon with CS4 and Quark 8 support, you'll see right away, besides a couple pre-flight errors and different things along those lines, is that it's showing us it's a Quark file, QuarkXPress file, version 5. The customer did say it's a quite old file and it's causing him problems and see if we could help. So someone along the line decided to just name it .indd and see if that would turn it magically into InDesign file. And obviously it did not. We can see here clearly what's going on with this file. Right, so basically get a preview of the images, which is a nice feature in FlightCheck. In any event, FlightCheck claims it's a Quark file, customer claims InDesign file, so let's just go in there and see if it's as easy as this. It'll warn us. If we want to change the extension, we'll say use.qxp. Now you see it's changed. It's changed into a Quark file here. So let's now Quark. And we see what happens there. This file opens in Quark without a problem. Okay, now if we save as Quark, and if we now switch over to InDesign and use Q2ID to convert Quark files into InDesign, we can now find that file, which the customer thought was InDesign, but was actually Quark, and now we can actually convert that Quark file into InDesign with Markzware's FlightCheck. Markzware's FlightCheck, sorry. FlightCheck's for checking, Q2ID, ID to Q, etc. for converting. And there we have it. It's converted, and that's a wrap. Another happy customer, another interesting case. Just wanted to share it with you. We can fix your bad InDesign files. Just send them over to sales, or send an email to sales@markzware.com, and we'll tell you where to send your files. We can pre-flight your files with FlightCheck. You see how handy FlightCheck was there. Just to give you a quick overview on what that file is. The customer didn't know. I knew, because FlightCheck told me. It was simple as dragging and dropping. And we have our conversion tools, Q2ID, Quark to InDesign, and ID to Q, InDesign to Quark, and of course, Pub to ID, Publisher, Microsoft Publisher to InDesign. All right, David signing off. Have a great day, and hope this helped you.
Yeah.